Hi, good morning. Happy Tuesday to you. I was just doing my eyebrows. I did this one. That one's done. You can tell the difference. I just wanted to say hello and good morning. And I hope that you have a wonderful day. Let you know that. I'm up early and getting some stuff done this morning. I have an appointment this morning. I am drinking some black coffee. And I have my sunscreen, which is the Aveeno Baby 50 SPF. I have the Beach Bay from L'Oreal mixed in with that. And then I use the Fit Me Foundation, Maybelline Fit Me Foundation in 120, and it's dewy. And then I use the Milani Sun-Kissed Bronzer and the Milani Tea Rose blush. And then I use the Wet n Wild brows. And I use the Milani eyeshadow primer. So anyway, I was just wondering how your day is going, how your evening went last night. I hope that you slept well. Did you sleep pretty good? I did and didn't, I would say. It's the usual. It's the usual for me. So I am going to be gone for a little bit this morning, and then I'm coming back and hopefully getting some stuff done. So I went into our backyard last night or yesterday, and we had a raised. I'm gonna just go ahead and do my eye makeup now. We had a raised garden. I'm gonna use the strobing stick on under my eyebrows real quick. And it needed to be, the plants were all dead in there, you know what I mean? And it needed to be fixed and cleaned up a little bit. Oh, I wanted to tell you also, if you're interested, that I used the Maybelline Fit Me and Translucent over the Milani eyeshadow primer. Anyway, so it has been raining here and we have a lot of leaves on the ground. And it has caused like the dampness, and I can't move the leaves hardly. So I have to wait, I guess, until it dries out a little bit to really rake those leaves. I'm using the Maybelline 10Q. This is the Expert Wear. This is the Mocha Motion little palette. It's a good little, quick get ready palette, I feel like. It's got a good, I like this color a lot. If you watched older videos of mine, I talked about how I've had this palette for a really long time, and I thought none of the colors were all that great on me. And that's what I do, is I kind of keep things and then go back to them and find that, oh well. And I tried it again on the video, and I'm like, well, I kind of like that color on my skin tone. It looks pretty good. So that's nice. Save me some money to go and buy a new palette or something. I can just use what I already have. Anyway, so that's something that needs to be done. I'm gonna use some of this gray right here. Is actually rake leaves. I got all the plants, all the dead plants out of the planters. This is really our first time having a raised garden, and I guess I did okay. I did okay at it. We had green beans that were not, they did not have to be what, like held up or what have you. I forgot what it's called, the trellis, or it didn't have to, they weren't string beans that way, but they were beans, and it was great. And then we had broccoli, Brussels sprouts. So I'm just learning. I bought cucumbers that were pickling cucumbers instead of regular cucumbers. And I wasn't prepared to pickle, even though I do like pickles. So I kind of wasted those cucumbers. I tried cutting them up into a salad, and they just weren't very good. And so I made that mistake. I should have pickled them. But I felt overwhelmed, I guess. And so I feel kind of bad that those plants, I feel like, kind of were wasted. The cucumber plants. We did have some animals come in the backyard and eat them, like some possum or something, raccoon. Happy New Year, you guys. Let's see. Where is my little brush? So anyway, that was something that I did yesterday. Do you guys have any gardens like that that you, or do you have a winter garden maybe? I had lettuce and some herbs too. So I'm not sure where my little tiny brush is. Oh, yeah, here, it's right in front of my face as usual. Mm-hmm. I'm going to put some of that gray down below. I looked online to see, do I cut the plants off or do I pull them out? I mean, if I pull, because I didn't know if they'll restart again next year or what will happen. And so what I did was I just cut them off because I figured if they don't restart, then all of that can go back into the soil and make it richer for the next time that I plant something, make that soil richer. So, but I really liked having that raised garden. And for the most part, I would say, I'm using some of the darker color too. So I had broccoli before in the past, by the way, in case you've never done broccoli before, I can tell you my little experience with it is, you get those little white moths that lay their eggs in the broccoli and or on the leaves of the broccoli, maybe. I'm not sure where they lay their eggs, but I would bring the broccoli in and I washed it and everything, and then we would eat it, right? And then I heard, oh, you should use vinegar to soak your vegetables in, because then it draws everything out if you've missed anything. And I thought, okay, well, I'll do that. So I'm using the NYX Jumbo Stick in black bean. And so I did. I soaked the broccoli in some vinegar, water with vinegar, I should say. And normally I would have just rinsed really good and, you know, well, there were the larvae in the broccoli. And when I soaked it, the larva came out, obviously, and were floating at the top, and it really grossed me out. So good morning to you. I'm sorry, you guys, telling you this gross story as you start your day. Actually, you probably will see this in the evening because I take a while to upload, it seems, so. But anyway, that was one of my experiences with broccoli that I'm always forever going to. If I have broccoli, I'm going to, or really all the vegetables, except for like tomato or something. I'm going to, which I had some tomato plants too. I'm going to make sure and soak them in vinegar water. So I used to work at this little restaurant. It was all organic deliciousness. And we had a garden right out back. And I was like, it was really small. So I was the prep cook and / server as needed, that kind of thing. It was really fun. It was really neat, cute place. Anyway, we used to go outside and get lettuce and all that. And really quickly, I just wanted to let you know that I'm going to, that's not the one. Let's see here. Well, I'm gonna use that Mad for Matte Nude Mood. Oh my, thing just fell in it, sorry. Mad for Matte, the e.l.f., and I'm gonna use the dark color there to just cover what I just did. Wow, I look super close. Anyway, we used to go in the garden and get what we needed. It was so cool, you guys, and like lettuce or herbs, whatever it was. And then we had these big huge sinks, and We didn't use vinegar. What I'm getting at is this, which is we use lemon juice. So I would fill up those sinks with water and then squeeze lemons in there, squeeze lemon, you know, the juice out of the lemon, and all the bugs would come out, of course. And then we would, they would be clean, and then I'd rinse them and all that. Anyway, I'm sure I've ate so many bugs and larva and all that stuff over the years. Alrighty, almost done. I don't know if I'm too close still. I'm gonna use a little tiny bit of the Fit Me. Like I do this, I just touch it and it's got that little round circle. Touch it, little round circle. It just puts just enough there to kind of put a little foundation back where I just kind of rubbed it off. And I feel it gives a pressure look. Or it makes me feel like it does. Pardon me. So I'm drinking, like I said, black coffee. So you know what that means. I'm trying to do some fasting today. I feel so much better when I do. So much better. I feel lighter. I feel my whole body is happy when I do. My brain's not, or my, you know, appetite's not. I'm using these Maybelline Sky High mascara. Anyway, so that's something I might do today, is work on the backyard a little bit if it is a little drier today. We have a blower, but it's, you know, it's a chargeable blower. So it has the battery pack, you know, battery deal on it. But it just isn't super strong. And so I really need to get out there with a rake and do it that way. Do you have gardens, like I was asking, or something like that you take care of? Do you have chickens? We were thinking about getting chickens, but they're a lot of work, aren't they? And I mean, we never go anywhere. I say this like I was going to say, and then if you go somewhere, you have to have someone come over and take care of them. Well, who's going to do that? But we don't really go anywhere, but we hope to someday go places and travel and all that good stuff. We rarely are gone overnight, you know, so, but it would be nice to have farm fresh eggs. I do have my brother-in-law, my sister-in-law, they have chickens and we can get eggs from them, which is really cool. But, anyway, that's a thought. Do you have any chickens or any kind of farm animals? All right, I'm going to finish this coffee up, put some lipstick on and be off. I hope that you have a wonderful day today. Let's see, what should I put on my... Something else that I have done before is the cheek heat. I have used it on my lips before. Let me try that, a little bit of it. Just not full on just this, but it's real light. Super light, and then put something on over that. I think I'll use some of the butter gloss from NYX, and this is the Praline. I kind of like that. It's nice and light. Okay. Alrighty. Well, let's see. Trying to stay on track with the things that I wanted to get done. I wish that for you as well. Stay on track, stay focused. Something that, like yesterday, so for me, I wanted to, as I've said before, read my Bible in the morning, have it be something that's priority. And I did not yesterday, but I did later in the day, because part of me was like, okay, well, I didn't in the morning, so I blew it today. I'll just do it tomorrow. And it didn't feel right, and it would weigh on me, and it would, knowing me, it would probably make me sort of not make it happen again, but I can tend to, you know, do that. I don't know exactly how to, it's not self-sabotage, but it's, you know, it's something that I struggle with doing, and I want to do it. I love it when I do it. But anyway, so what I did instead of waiting until today and thinking, okay, well, I'm just going to do it right tomorrow and read my Bible in the morning before my day, and just don't worry about it today, I did it last night, and it was right for me to do that. So anyway, I just wanted to encourage you that if you, for some reason, aren't doing what you know and desire in your heart to do, and you're struggling to, you know, really make yourself be different, then do it later if you can in the day. Try and still keep it in that same day and do it later. And there's something about still doing these things, you know, or don't do it, or whatever it is, whatever it is that you are wanting. I hope you have an awesome day. I will be thinking about you. I always do. And I will see you tomorrow. I'm going to go do something with my bangs. Maybe it's not so bad. I don't know. I know my friend tells me, don't put your bangs to the side, but I think I meant to have no bangs because it really bothers me to have this right here. I don't know. It just does. And I can fix them and make them look better. Anyway, you guys, thanks for listening to me. Thanks for watching. Have an awesome, awesome day. I will talk to you later, and stay focused, and you got this. All right.